Hey everyone, today we will talk about how to design an API rate limiter. So let's get started. Let's talk about functional requirements quickly. This system should be able to limit number of requests a user can send to an API endpoint within a time window. This system should be able to throw a 4-to-9 HTTP status error message whenever the user exceeds the limit. The system should be able to monitor requests among multiple servers. Let's talk about non-functional requirements. The system should have very low latency. The system should be highly available. Let's talk about a system we are going to design. We are going to design rolling window-based rate limiter, where only Y number of requests per user can be allowed over last Z minutes. So for example, a user X sends request 1 to an API endpoint. Rate limiter will check whether this request has passed the limit or not. If the request has passed the limit, has breached the limit, rate limiter will block the request and will send back 4-to-9 HTTP status. If not, the rate limiter will keep allowing passing all the requests to API endpoint until this limit is breached, and API endpoint will keep sending 200 HTTP status code in response to user directly. So, how we are going to do this? We are going to maintain a sliding window kind of mechanism internally, where for each user we are going to track for last 4 minutes, for last X minutes, or for last Z minutes, how many number of requests we have allowed so far. So, for example, here you may see for each and every minute, we are tracking what is the current number of requests we are allowing. Also, we are tracking what has been the total number of requests so far in this rolling window. Let's do this for our real users. So there can be two types of users. Number one, logged in users. Number two, non-logged in users. So let's say we want to build a system for both type of users, but we want to have dedicated quota for those limits for each API endpoint for logged in users. But for non-logged in users, we want to have a cumulative rate limiter across all API endpoints. So for example, let's say for each API endpoint, we are having primary rate limit and secondary rate limit. So for logged in users, let's say for post endpoint, okay, we are saying a user can send not more than 500 requests over last 15 minutes. Also, we cannot allow more than 100 requests per minute for this logged in user. But for non-logged in user, across all the API endpoints, we cannot send more than 250 requests over last 15 minutes, and that too with the limit of 50 requests per minute. So those are primary rate limits and secondary rate limits per API endpoint. Now, how we are going to do this? We are going to rate limit all the requests for logged in users based on their user ID. For non-logged in users, we can do it based on their IP address. Now, we are going to maintain a hash map in the cache and wants to maintain the sliding window accordingly. So let's say for each user ID and endpoint ID basis, we can make a key, and value can be a sliding window where each epoch represents each minute level time unit, and request count is primarily all the number of requests which has been served so far per minute level. Okay, the same can be done for non-logged in users as well. So here, a maximum total number of epoch entries in the value, okay, is going to be our rolling window, and the sum of request of all the request count across epochs is going to be our primary rate limit. To maintain secondary rate limit, we can just quickly check in the system whether a request count at epoch level is more than this particular request or not. If it's more than that, we are not going to make any entry. We are going to block it. If yes, we will make the entry in the system. Okay. So this is quite straightforward so far. Let's try to do this for all set of users. Okay. So let's say for a user ID X and endpoint ID, let's say 96. Okay. We make a key X underscore 96, let's say. And this is going to have, for example, last 15 minute. So we will have last 15 minute epochs here in the value. And for each epoch, what was the request count served by the system so far? This is something which we are going to maintain. Also, we are going to make sure the request count at epoch level cannot exceed 100. Okay. So simply we will check if some of the requests of last 15 epochs is greater than 500. If yes, we are going to block it. If no, we are going to have second check if number of requests at particular epoch, at current epoch, is going to be more than 100. Again, we will block it. If not, we will pass it to the API endpoint, and then API endpoint can serve the response directly to the customer. Okay. Now let's talk about how we are going to design. Okay. But before that, see, there's a one problem here. Every time we are going to compute the sum of all the request count served so far, which is going to be a O(n) operation for n number of epochs. Doing this at a very large scale is going to be a problem. How we can make sure we do such operations like insertion, deletion, count, sum in O(n). Can we do this? Fortunately, yes. We can quickly do the reverse mapping of this particular key value pair and utilize the Redis sorted set where we can do all these operations in O(n). Now, since we are going to do the reverse mapping, the difference is going to be this. Previously, we were just maintaining last 15 epochs and each epoch level request count, ensuring epoch level request count doesn't exceed secondary limit and total sum of request count doesn't exceed primary limit. Now we are going to have all number of requests served so far. Okay. But again, making sure we don't have more than n number of requests. N means 500 number of requests. That means primary limit number of requests we can serve here. So we are going to make 500 entries. And for each request, we are going to maintain for which epoch this request came. How this is going to solve the problem? This is going to be solving a problem for us because in Redis sorted set, we can do a lot of operations in O(n) based on the child key. Okay, so let's have a look. So for example, we have logged in user, non-logged in users, and we are going to have rate limiter as a middleware at API gateway layer. Okay, so that all the requests gets filtered via API gateway, and API gateway checks with the help of rate limiter if this particular request needs to be passed or to be blocked. Okay, now this rate limiter will first load all the quota what we discussed earlier, all the primary and secondary rate limits per API level. Rate limiter will load all this data into cache, okay, and will also maintain all sliding windows per user level in cache only. Okay, now let's say we are storing all the sliding window, how to make sure that we are doing this faster enough so that this doesn't block this request serving at a large scale. Okay, let's have a look very quickly. So this is how the rate limiter algorithm is going to work. For each request, rate limiter is going to do the following. Number one, remove all entries older than the rolling window time for that particular user X. So let's say for last 15 minutes. Okay, so we are going to remove all the entries older than last 15 minutes. Very quickly add request entry for current epoch. Check if some of the total number of requests across all epochs is less than primary threshold. If not, block the request and send 429 HTTP status. Else, check if sum of number of requests for current epoch is less than secondary threshold. If not, again, return false, else return true. Okay. So this is very simple. And if you look at the first part, okay, that is only taking O log of N, which is again very efficient, but not much efficient. But at worst, we are going to have O log N overall time complexity for this particular algorithm, which is much better. Now, if you have noted, we are first writing at step B, rather reading, and we are checking later. Why we are doing this? This is primarily being done to avoid race condition. Obviously, we may delay unblocking user in such cases, but that should be fine for this particular use case, because this is helping us to avoid race condition. Now, since we have already built rate limiter so far, we have discussed algorithm, we have also discussed how we are maintaining the sliding window in the cache. Now, there can be multiple API gateway, okay? And if user tries to send the request across different API gateway, the total number of requests he can exceed actually the overall primary limit. Okay, how we are going to solve this? Obviously, we are going to have local cache, but to make sure the global quota is added, the global quota is being, is being treated as an overall policy. We need to make sure both local cache start syncing their data to centralized global cache with the help of sync service. So rate limiter, both the rate limiter will start loading one time quota into local cache. Now local cache will be pulled by sync service, and sync service will push it to centralized global cache. And rate limiter will also keep pulling the data from centralized global cache for all the users where there is no entry previously in the local cache. So for example, if a user sends API request via different API gateway, global quota might not breach. In order to avoid this, whenever the request comes from a new user, whenever there's a no entry in local cache for this user, rate limiter tries to check and load entry from global cache to local cache for that user if it exists. This will ensure that the global policy is being promised. Okay. Now, if a user sends bulk API request at same time, race condition may occur. How we are going to solve it? The rate limiter will start deleting all epochs older than 15 minutes. That's what we discussed. It will keep a log, first write and then read. Okay, that's again we have discussed. So that's how we have designed a distributed rate limiter. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.